the collapse of peace talks in Minsk, which frankly never really had much of a chance, is just going to cause violence to escalate here in eastern Ukraine. The 24 hours prior to those parties getting into the same room in the Belarusian capital, Ukraine said it had lost 15 of its soldiers. And we hear from a diplomat that in the last week alone, at least 67 civilians have lost their lives in the fighting here. We went to one of the key towns on the Ukrainian front line here against the separatists, Debaltseve, that has been under substantial shelling for the past days.
This road is the one lifeline for a key Ukrainian village separatists are encircling, and it's been shelled for days. Ukraine says it has thousands of troops here, but we did not see them, just the dead. And the destruction that took their lives, 12 reported killed here this day.
The belts of a pockmarked by the shelling, destroyed. You can hear shelling constantly in the background, but so few people left here, so many having fled for their lives.
But some cannot or won't leave and here tussle over food. About 100 here, they say, people who have farms, the elderly, those who can't leave, she says, it's scary, of course. The man adds, we're poor, what else are we to do? Underground, one light bulb and the sound of separatists nearing. However little there is left to fight over, Ukraine says it won't give up to Debaltseve. But it's the blasts, not their troops, dominating here. The neighbouring town, perhaps already in separatist hands. On the way out, we see Ukrainian reinforcements. The fight here, perhaps just beginning. The loss, the damage, irreversible.
The key issue is what comes after the Minsk talks. Now, there was always so much confusion as to who was going to attend, who the parties would have representing themselves, what day even the talks would have been on. And a diplomat with knowledge of them says that the atmosphere in the 2 hours in which the parties finally got in a room together was poisonous enough. It was clear it wasn't really going to go anywhere. It leaves really the decision now for the conflict not in the arms of diplomats, but in those fighting in eastern Ukraine here. The separatists increasingly confident, better equipped, moving towards that town, Debaltseve, saying they've taken a neighbouring village as well, and a real sense of fear in eastern Ukraine. Their momentum is growing, as is their use of heavy weaponry. Ukraine also firing back, I should say, with its artillery too, and separatists claiming that's causing a loss of civilian lives as well. But the fear being now, this is now an escalating war rather than a lengthy diplomatic standoff with clashes intermittent. Nick Paton Walsh, CNN, Sviatogorsk, eastern Ukraine.